try and see if the sound is working. Just making sure, there we go. Helps you turn the mic on. Right, first into Paul, one shot. Both of these players vying for a spot in the cup knockout. Peter playing with the blue bowls. He's the defending champion here. Paul with the black bowls. Good spot there. Paul just thinking about what's best to play here. Switching to the forehand. Just hung out there. Yeah, Peter's going to be a bit more aggressive now. Jack or bolt. Yeah, very good result. That will pick up the two. Right, two shots to Peter there. Peter takes a 2-1 lead now after two ends. Peter opting for a quarter short as opposed to three quarters that Paul had. Good start. It's not going to hang that, just one out. Trying to work out why his bowl didn't hang on there. Sometimes where you bowl it from, and Paul does play quite far over the mat, that will make a difference. It could get just stuck on the line and not come back from there. Whereas if it does this, he could finally goes underneath. It was in the area, that's good. Very good from Peter. Very consistent. Paul just over the pace down here. Is he going to hold? It's just going to start going. Just expecting that to hold. Again, I think it's where you bowl it from on this show mat, most certainly. Pete, you're just dropping again for another. Doesn't want to make it any bigger. Not too bad. Let's see what Paul does here. There's a few down. He's got to go again. Yeah. So you've got the weight to hold that line. I think he's good here. Took one away. So two shots. Peter takes a 4-1 lead now. 4-1. Currently, Peter top of this group with 6 points, and Paul's in third place with 4. So, in the context of this group, Paul is the one that really does need the points here. Give himself the best opportunity to qualify for tomorrow's cup competition. Otherwise, he could be destined for the plate. Aggressive start from Paul there, just trying to change something there. Good result, took Peter's shot bowl off. Right, good again. Will Paul go again at this or just try and drop on this backhand? Does look like a difficult hand or difficult mat to play weight on. Nice mat to draw on. Let us know where you're watching from. I can see the comments on the screen here. If you've got any questions, please let us know. Little ledge for Paul to drop on. Played it more pace this time. What's the jack? What's the jack? He's got it. Jack's still live. Big shot this. If Peter doesn't get, goes for the jack and misses, he's going to give himself best chance. That nice and wide. Is it going to hang? It's just going to goes off there. Doesn't like it. So, Paul should draw for the 4 here. Big end. Oh, he's going to try to go round them. Wow. Oof. He was going round them the way he played that. Hi, Derek. Thanks for joining us in Suffolk. So, 4 shots. Ball right back in this and in front now. 5-4 after 4 ends. Good end the way that ended up there for Paul. There was an opportunity there for Peter, wasn't there? It's a very difficult shot to play, especially on that hand. It just seems to hang on the edge of the mat there. Bit of support for Paul from back home. It's good to see. Yeah, good start, good bit of chalk. This will be the player's last game today. Both of these players got a very good delivery. Anyone looking to try and model your delivery on anybody, both of these players, very good static stance, works very well on these mats. As I say, Peter himself was the champion here last year, picking up the trophy. So we see Peter after the jack. Oh, he got a bit of chalk. It did touch. Paul knows what he's got to do here. He's got to get behind the jack with this one. I know where that jack's going. Oh, doesn't like this one. Looks a bit quick. Looks a bit quick. Yeah, it's easily done. All right, fancy Peter this time. A bit more at it, yeah. He's got the bowl, if not. Well, he got a result. We've taken the shot with that one. He's got all the back position, so again. Paul's just got to draw the shot here. Drop onto the shot bowl, drop back. Doesn't want to sit on top of the jack. Just playing some good bowls down this forehand, this end. Needs another one now. That looked quick out of the hand, I must say. Yeah, he knows it. Well, what does Peter go for here? He has got a chance for three or four here. I think you've got to go for this. You can play it positively. Try and push the Paul's bowl away. If you're tight, if you get the jack, it's all good. Yeah, foot out to the line. Yeah, he's in the area. Wants the bowl. Got the jack. That's enough. Loses one bowl, but jack back was the result he was after. I'm just checking if it's two or three here. Oh, it was a touch, as it's four shots to. So, four picked up from Paul, one in, a four dropped by Paul. So important when you do pick up a big end. If you're the player who picks the big end up, you've got to back it up the next end. So that's 8-5 now to Peter. Five ends played. Couple of big fours, last couple of ends. Bad start. Paul should fancy drawing this. Don't if he's quite worked out his line coming back this way just yet. It's definitely out nice and wide. I just don't know if he's going to get back enough. Quiet. His own bowl that stopped him. He's changed Peter's shot. Oh, it's tight. Wow. Unusual. Often you see Peter doing that. He caught between two shots really there. Paul's got to try and just lift his own and get underneath. He's playing it just through. Oh, it's got enough for the shot. Moving the jack back. Peter's gonna go back to this four backhand now. Round the front two bowls. He's good here. It's all on the weight. Weight's good. Good bowl. Very good. Big bowl from Paul needed now. Don't know if he gets to it on this forehand. Danger is he pushes one of Peter's short bowls up. What's he doing here? Wow, see what he does here. He might be going underneath here. Wow, he's trying it underneath. Needs to jack here. Oh, he's got a bit of luck there. Yeah, very much so, a bit of luck. He wants it to fall. He's taken shot, yeah, one shot or two. Paul there. Certainly not what he was playing for. He'll take it. 8-6 after six ends. So just confirmation. 8-6 six ends, halfway through. Peter with the slender lead. So it's important, both these players really want the win here. Paul needs the points, he would argue, more than Peter. Out the hand as well. You can see straight away. I believe it is Gary. Yeah, I've not mentioned it yet. Should be a good game, hopefully. Switching now to this backhand. Does swing nice if you... So that's where you got to play it from. And we'll drop right back now. Yep, very good. Peter sticking to this forehand. Not quite. I don't know. See what the marker thinks. Yep, Paul holding still. And Peter, thanks for joining us in Niagara Falls. And I just imagine quite an exotic location to be watching from. Out there again, he just holds here and then all of a sudden starts to come. Here it comes, very good. That's a great bowl, really good bowl there from Paul. Here, throw it out to the line and across his body, trying to take the two black bowls away. Oh, that's a hell of a shot. What a shot. Absolutely perfect. The only thing he didn't do is stay for the four. Three shots. Great shot. Shot of the day so far. Certainly shots I've seen. So 11 shots to Peter. 11-6. Seven ends played. Great bowl. Absolutely fantastic bowl. Again, for those of you looking at how to play weight on your backhand, great example there. It's probably the most difficult shot to play. Get that sort of weight on your backhand. effort. It's like a punch there for Paul after holding a good, like a good two there. He had to get another one in and around. This looks well under the line. That should go. That is a very bendy side, that. Yeah, both sides are swinging a lot, but that this side, closest to where we are, is definitely bending more. The players are tending to stick to the other side where possible. Of course, we are playing on a sports floor, so it's not 100% flat. So you get that. It just goes across the line now. Where Paul's playing that from? I'll talk to him after the game about that, but he's not worked it out yet. You can't do that. Where he bowls it from, it won't allow you to do that. But it does swing that hand, so he wants to play that shot. Let's see why he does. Good recovery bowl here. Just needs to run. It's probably in for second there. That's what makes playing these mats on the hard floor very, I say difficult. It's not difficult, it's just different from what lots of players are used to now. So used to playing mats on top of the indoor. It's all on the weight again, Paul. Yeah, you're good here. One shot to Paul there. So 11-7 now, 8-10's played. Just wait for confirmation. There we go. 11-7 and 8-10's. So Paul's decided to switch it up and go long. Trying to change something. So this hand here, he's finding very well. It's all just getting his weight. It's a bit quick again. He's just wasted too many bowls on that forehand. He's finding a good line. Unfortunately, you can't be giving Peter this many goes. Going to get your first bowl there. Expressions, Paul, sometimes are quite funny. He's a bit different here. Tight and light this time. Really does need to win this end. Getting back in this match. Does he go for the jack now? You've got to try something different, Paul. Looks like he's setting himself up for that. Yeah. That's okay. Not the best result. He's got the toucher in the ditch. Just trying to drop another one in here. Yeah, very good. Yeah, that's good. Jack will point back. Go back. He's got to get this perfect though. Just arrive at this, not too much. Giving it a go. Just not going to move. is going to be the match really here. Peter will draw in for the third, you would imagine. Puts him, should put him out of sight really. Yeah. So three shots, 14-7. Did have a chance there, Paul. So 14-7 after 9. If you ever got any questions, please let us know. I'll try and get those answered for you. If it's about the rules or the competition or just our events in general or this match. Just hanging off a paw on that hand. Seeing where the point of which Peter delivers his bowl from. It's slightly different to Paul's. Plus, I think he's playing with Taylor International, so that's slightly bendier than Paul's Taylor Aces. Very popular choice here this weekend, Taylor Ace. Better here from Paul. Just going to go now. He's just getting frustrated with that line now. The mat's certainly feels, Paul feel what the mat's beating him here as well when he comes off. Peter showing what you need to do on it. Now Paul looking to change something. Yeah, he's after this jack. Right, jack off. Now we'll play there again. Players can do that twice without penalty. We go again. Still 14-7. It's a 10th end being played of 12. And a good start again from Peter. Good effort from Paul, just falling short. As you just joined, it's 14-7 currently to Peter. This is the 10th end. As Peter's just drawing away again, he's good. He has perfect weight this time. Perfect.
We still looking good?
He's got to keep drawing away here, Paul. Got nothing behind it. This looks a bit quicker. Should hang on though. Yeah, it's good there. Just trying to draw another. Quite. You've got to try something different here, Paul. You've got to try and hit this. Got the back position. Backhand. Close. Yep, got the shot. Good hit. Needs to really try and be scoring more than one here, though. Good piece, it would be too disappointed dropping one this end. It's Peter after here. Is he after the check or the bowl? He'll check onto the bowl. Oh, he's got the bowl out clean. I think Paul can't believe he got the bowl out there without moving the jack as well. Well, jack in the corner for two. That's all you got, Paul. You need to draw it otherwise. You need this. You need two shots. He's underneath it, I think. Well, you might have held on for shot. Yep, 1-2 Paul, so he stays in this match just about. So 14-8 now after 10. Looking to bring you one more match this evening before the end of play. That's going to be around about 10 past 6 local time, 10 past 5 UK time. So, just confirming it is 14-8. This is 10 ends played, there's 2 ends to go. With the marker having a fight with the scoreboard. Starting it from Paul. That's okay. If he got a bit of chalk, it would have been pretty good. He's got to try and score multiple on this end. At least two to give him a chance for a draw on the last end. Yeah, I was saying the last game of the day will be on at 10 past 5 UK time. It's going to be 10 past 6 here. So that's just over an hour's time. That'll be the last match that we'll bring you today after this one. Trouble again at this end. Trying to draw it off. Bad ball, but one's no good to you. Gotta try and change something. Peter's just been very, very consistent in this match. Also struggled to find any consistency. Got to go for this. This is drawing again. It's almost taking the fact the game's gone. Peter just drawing in for another. This will be a match. Yep, so one shot to Peter there, so that will be 15-8 after 11 ends. Fifteen eight, 11 ends. bit short that time. So, last end. Peter will be taking the 3 points here. Yeah, good start from Peter again. On this display, he's going to be certainly one of the favourites again to take this title. Playing very well. Paul's just not found this mat. Not consistently anyway. It's been his problem. Fully expecting Paul to say about that line on the this near side. You have to be wide, but it's where you start your body from. You can see where Paul plays. He's right over the other side. This side lets you do it. The other side, it doesn't. See where it just bit there and come back. On the other side, it will not let you do that. You need to work these out quite quickly on these mats, what you can and can't do. See, just Peter's just very consistent, just drawing away whilst Paul's just struggled there. And he's out too wide again. Another big counting coming here, if not too careful here. See, Peter's just found the right line here for his. And then we'll just cover up that jack. Very good. Just leaving nothing for Paul. Paul had his opportunity with his third bowl, but missed. So playing it with white now. Just missed this. There's your four shots. And that's the victory for Peter. 19-8 in the end. So we'll bring you the match. I'll be up against Alex Clay in around about an hour's time. So join us then. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you again hopefully in about an hour's time.